Good evening everyone, myself Akshita. Welcome to StudentChem. Today we are going to start a new chapter from Organic Chemistry by Clayden. It's a very good book for understanding the organic chemistry. It consists of total 43 chapters. Among that, we are first going to discuss about the chapter number 6, that is nucleophilic addition to carbonyl compounds. So most commonly used carbonyl compounds are aldehydes and ketones. So first we'll discuss about the what is nucleophilic addition reaction. The reaction in which a nucleophile forms a sigma bond with the electron deficient center is called nucleophilic addition reaction. So for example, I'm taking the ketone compound. It is a ketone. In the presence of nucleophile, when this nucleophile approaches towards the carbonyl carbon, it gets activated, results in the breakdown of this pi bond. Due to this, a partial negative and partial positive charge is formed. Here, the electronegativity difference is higher for oxygen, so it forms a partial negative charge, and here for carbon, it forms a partial positive charge. Now, this nucleophile attack towards the electron deficient center, that is carbon, results in the formation of new sigma bond between the carbon and nucleophile. Here, the oxygen gets a negative charge. To stabilize it, protonation takes place. Here, after protonation, the final product is formed. Let's see some more examples among this. Let's see some more examples about this. NaCN is acting as a reagent. It consists of cyanide ion as a nucleophile and water is acting as a proton donation. Here we are using sulfuric acid for the activation of carbonyl carbon. So there are some nucleophiles which cannot activate the carbonyl carbon. Those are weak nucleophiles. So to differentiate between the strong nucleophile and weak nucleophile, we know that strong nucleophiles are strong bases, whereas weak nucleophiles are weak bases. Here, if the strong base is sterically hindered, then this strong base acts as weak nucleophile. So, to know which is a strong base and which is a weak base, follow the events table, which is available in the description box. So let's discuss about this example. So here the cyanide ion acts as a nucleophile and attack on the carbonyl carbon, results in the formation of new sigma bond between the carbon and cyanide ion. This after protonation forms . So this type of compounds are called cyanohydrins. So what is cyanohydrin? If both OH and CN are attached to same carbon, then if this OH and CN is attached to same carbon, then that type of compounds are called the cyanohydrin compounds. Let's see another example. Results in the formation of cyanohydrin compound. As we see, OH and the nucleophile going to attack here, results in the cyanohydrin formation. Now we are going to see about the different types of reagents reacting with aldehydes in the nucleophilic addition reaction. NaBH4. What is its function? Its function is to donate the H- ion. So it is the H- is hydride. The source of hydride is the BH4, that is sodium borohydride. Apart from sodium borohydride, that is lithium aluminium hydride, dibal, etc. These all are the source of hydrate ion donor. So, apart water and alcohol, they act as proton donor. So, whenever you find a sodium borohydride in it as a reagent, it means that it is the source of hydrate ion donor. Hydrate donor. So let's see some examples. Here, this sodium borohydride acts as hydride donor. This attacks on the carbonyl carbon, results in the formation of bond between the carbon and hydride ion. This, after protonation, results in the formation of alcohol, which is the final product. Our product is alcohol. Let's see some more examples. So, in this case, sodium borohydride is acting as hydride donor. This attack on the carbonyl carbon results in the formation of new sigma bond. That is hydrogen. This, on further protonation, gives alcohol. Next reaction is, here isopropyl alcohol is acting as a proton donor. So it donates the proton, and sodium borohydride donates the hydride ion. So the resultant is this. On further protonation, forms alcohol. Now, here also the same thing it applies. And further protonation, it forms alcohol. Let's see some other examples. Now, we will compare the reactivity of ketones and aldehydes towards the nucleophilic addition reaction. So, compared to ketone, aldehydes reacts more faster than ketone. Aldehyde reactivity is more faster than ketone. The reason behind this is, in aldehyde, aldehyde, the formed carbocation is primary carbocation, whereas the cation formed here is the secondary carbocation. This secondary carbocation is stabilized by the adjacent R groups, whereas here no stabilization takes place. And we know that tertiary carbocation is stable than secondary, and secondary is stable than primary. We know that stable the compound, lesser will be the reactivity. Here the carbocation is less stable, so its reactivity is high when compared to ketone. And the another reason for this is steric hindrance. Another reason is steric hindrance. Whenever the nucleophile whenever the nucleophile come and attack at the carbon, here it is less space when compared to here. These two presence of these two groups results in the steric hindrance, and nucleophile finds very difficult to attack on the this carbon when compared to this carbon. So let's see some examples. This is benzaldehyde. This is acetophenone. Here H is replaced by CH3. So acetophenone. So here the reactivity is given as here in both the reactions they form same type of compound, but here the reaction is very fast, here the reaction is slow. Why? Because here due to the steric hindrance between these two groups, nucleophile find very difficult to attack here. It takes some time to reaction occur. Here it takes very fast reaction due to the absence of steric hindrance. Let's see some next we will going to see about the second reagent, that is organometallic reagent. Next type of reagent is organometallic reagent. So what is organometallic reagent? If there is a direct bond between the carbon atom and the metal, then that type of reagents are called organometallic reagents. Example of organometallic reagents are methyl lithium, n-butyl lithium, lithium, etc. So let's see some examples. Here methyl lithium is acting as an organometallic reagent. Here lithium is more electro positive, so it gets partial positive charge, and methyl gets partial negative charge. So here methyl is acting as a nucleophile. Here for this type of reagent we should take the solvents like aprotic solvents. So what are aprotic solvents? This includes THF, ether, etc. Okay. So first of all, this methyl activates the carbonyl carbon and breaks down the pi bond, results in the formation of new sigma bond. Here there is a new sigma bond between the carbon and the methyl. This on further protonation forms the final product, that is alcohol. Let's see some more examples. Here in this example, this methyl is acting as a nucleophile and water is acting as a protonation, results in the formation of new sigma bond between the carbon and methyl, which is actually a nucleophile, which on further protonation gives here. In this case, phenyl is acting as a nucleophile. This, on further protonation, forms alcohol. Here, when aldehyde used as a substrate, the resultant formed is a secondary alcohol. Whereas, if ketone is using as a substrate, the formed product is a tertiary alcohol. Here, the OH group is attached to the carbon, which consists of two carbon atoms, so it is called as tertiary. Whereas here, only one carbon is attached, so it is called a secondary alcohol. Now, here in this reaction, butyl is acting as a nucleophile, so the result results in the formation of this. After further protonation, gives now this here phenyl is acting as a nucleophile. This, on further protonation, gives alcohol. Now, we are going to see the reaction of aldehydes or ketones with alcohol. It gives hemiacetal. Let's see the structure of acetyl and hemiacetal. This is called hemiacetal. This is called acetal. So, if only one OR group is present, then that type of compounds are called hemiacetal. If two OR groups are present, then we will call it as acetal. Now, we will see the formation of hemiacetal from the aldehydes or ketones by reacting with alcohol. So, now we will take the aldehyde. This, on reaction with ethanol. Here we are using the ethanol as an alcohol. It results in the formation of hemiacetal. Let's see its mechanism. In the presence of ethanol, this oxygen contains one lone pair of electrons which attack the carbonyl carbon, results in the breakdown of pi bond and formation of new sigma bond. As it is donating its electrons, it results in the positive charge. And here O minus. Here, one more molecule of ethanol X. Here this bond breaks and this hydrogen is accepted by this ethanol, results in the formation of this lone pair electron is taken by H plus ion, it results one positive charge. Now this hydrogen, this bond is broken and taken by this positive charge, and this hydrogen is accepted by O minus, results in the formation of hemiacetal. Let's see some more examples. In this, intermolecular rearrangement takes place, results in the formation of lactate. That is, this structure can also be written as here, the lone pair electrons present in the oxygen attack on the carbonyl carbon, results in the breakdown of pi bond. This on further results as here this bond breaks, accepted by positive charge, and this hydrogen is accepted by negative charge on the oxygen. This on further results and form which is a lactone. Let's see some more examples. So here in this case the CN is acting as a nucleophile. So the A product will be this is the A product. This on further acid hydrolysis, always remember on acid hydrolysis CN is converted to COOH, that is acid group. So we get the B product as OH. This is the B product. Now let's see the second example. Here CN is acting as nucleophile. So our expected A product will be this. So this on further reduction. So lithium aluminium hydride always acts as a reduction, results in the formation of CH2 and NH2. Thank you.